Factor Trinomials, Introduction to Radicals. A radical sign looks like this, where a square root has an understood index of 2, and all other roots, we use the index, which is this number right here, of the radical sign. Radicals are where we take the roots, or we can think of it, the base. So for example, here, if our exponent and the index match, it will just be whatever the number is inside. And so in this case, it would be 4. Here we have the square root of 25. If you remember your perfect squares, then it's the number that we multiplied times itself to get 25, which would be 5. Square root of 6 we can't do because it is not a perfect square, and its only factors are 2 and 3, which are both prime numbers. So one of the ways that we can simplify radicals is by breaking down the numbers using prime factorization. We want to eliminate or simplify radicals where possible. Meaning that if the exponent is greater than or equal to the index, we can simplify it. Then we multiply the numbers inside radical. Back together if there's no more simplification possible. Let's take a look at our two examples here. So here we have the number of 343. First thing that I want to do is I want to do a prime factorization for it. So I need to find something that I can divide 343 by. It's not divisible by 2. If I add my digits, it's not divisible by 3. It doesn't end in 5 or 0, so it's not divisible by 5. So the next one I want to try is 7. So if I divide 7 into 343, well, we're going to get that this is, whoops, that's my, actually write a 3 there. 343 divided by 7 is going to be 49. Well, 49 I know is divisible by 7. And that's going to give me 7. So what I have now inside my radical is 7 cubed. My index here is 2. So one of the ways that we can do this is that we can take the exponent divided by the index. If the exponent is larger than the index. So here we have 3 divided by 2, which is going to give me 1, with a remainder of 1. This 1 here represents the exponent that comes out. This right here represents the exponent that stays in. So what that means is that I have 7 to the 1 that comes out. I still have the square root, and I have a 7 to the 1 that stays inside. We don't normally write those, so we can just simplify this down as 7 square root 7. And we have simplified that radical. Let's take a look at our second example. This time we have a cubic root. I need to break 144 down. The first thing that comes to mind here is that this is 12 times 12. Okay, it doesn't do much for my prime factorization, but 12 and 12 are easy to break down. In fact, if I just take down 12, I can double my exponents. So 12 is 2 times 6, and 6 is going to be 2 times 3. So 12 is 2 squared times 3. And if we have 2 of those, that means I'm going to have 2 to the 4th times 3 squared. So we have the cubic root of 2 to the 4th times 3 squared. Well, 2 is less than 3, so we don't even have to do anything with that. That's just going to stay inside. But 4 is larger than 3, so we're going to take 4 divided by 3. That's going to give us 1 with a remainder of 1. Remember, this goes out. This stays in. So we're going to have 1, 2 that comes out. It's still going to be the cubic root. We're going to have 1, 2 that stays in. And we're still going to have the 3 squared. So this is becomes 2 cubic root of 2 times, whoops, that was supposed to be 3 squared, 9, or in other words, this is 2 cubic root of 18. We have simplified this radical.